an extremely low water bill and a low rate for years. Water is a precious commodity. It has to be collected, it has to be treated, it has to be piped, and the pipes have to be cleaned and straightened out every few years. Therefore, the increase in the water rate, in my opinion, is a reasonable one. Now, it is not unreasonable, though, to question the $300 for 3 months.
Well, let's say 2 years ago, was it $24 3 months 2 years ago?
Right.
What's a fair amount today, then, using the same amount of water? How much has it really?
Well, it's going up about 70%.
70%, so that means she should be paying...
And we cannot afford that. This is ridiculous.
Well, you got to pay for your water.
Uh-huh, but this is ridiculous.
Well,
we're senior citizens here,
yeah.
And my husband is the only one that's working. This is the only income we have.
$300 is a mistake.
Sure, but and 70%, you're talking about 70% of $24,
that's right.
Which would be around $18, $19,
right.
And
right.
Add that on top
add
of 24.
On to 24.
So it still shouldn't be costing her more than $50 every 3 months.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
All right, well, ma'am, then I'd...
Why is it costing me more?
Well,
you need to come down to our water department.
But they keep putting me off. They
well,
don't want
tell them you talk to the mayor, ma'am, and if I had a pipe coming into my house with no meter on it, I wouldn't pay anything.
Mm-hmm.
I just wouldn't do it. But, of course, that's your fight.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Line two, your question, please.
Referring back to the historical commission, which the mayor has been mandated by the council to appoint.
No, wait a minute. No, not mandated. It's an ordinance which says that I have the opportunity to appoint a commission. That is not a mandate.
It's an opportunity.
It's an opportunity.
That's a difference.
Which I may debate seriously.
Is that the end of your question, sir?
Well, Your Honor, I look at St. James Church and you talk about the progress that the city can make. And when I see the demolition of a structure like that making way for a parking lot, I don't see that as progress. How do you feel about that?
There's some other people who may see that as progress. I'm not going to debate a single building, but I do think that there's a serious
debate
as to whether or not a structure should be maintained, which has not been supported, by the way, by the church, and they have not made the appropriations to rehabilitate it, should be maintained in the condition that was in, because someone feels it's historic.
Before I go back to the phones, Mayor, I want to, you talked a bit earlier about your gubernatorial aspirations, and I wanted to find out from you if you have any feelings that these rumors about this investigation on your campaign funds is going to continue. It's not letting up. We only see something in the press occasionally, but the rumors continue, and I hear them in Trenton, and I'm wondering how they're affecting you and your future.
Well, they don't affect me at all. One of the things about public life is that you have to be subject to investigations. You have to be subject to allegations. That is a part of the job. As Harry Truman used to say, if you can't stand the heat, then get out of the kitchen. I have no fears about any investigations. If they continue right on until 1981, then fine. I have no problems with that. I don't know what prompted them.
Politically motivated, do you think?
I wouldn't say that. I think that I have a great deal of respect for our criminal justice system. I think that public figures and officials are subject to allegations at all times. People tend to think that if you're in public life, then the tax money that comes into City Hall somehow goes into the mayor's pocket. We've had all kinds of allegations over the years. We've had people who have, in fact, misdirected, if we want to use that word, public money. So those are the kind of things that you have to deal with.
Do you hear the rumors, too, that you might be indicted, that sort of thing?
Oh, I don't. I hear all kinds of rumors. I hear rumors that other people will be indicted. Indictments, by the way, are not any indication that you have been proven guilty.
Just a charge.
It's a charge.
Just an accusation.
Just like any other allegation. I have no problem with that. People get indicted, people get tried, people get acquitted. Some people get convicted. I have no problem with that.
But I'm trying to find, would you expect that might happen because of the scope of the investigation so far?
I wouldn't expect anything outside of the fact that I will cooperate with any investigation that anyone alleges any misconduct of myself or my administration. I, in this particular investigation, appeared before the grand jury at my request. I spent 4.5 hours testifying. I did not take the Fifth Amendment.
But you won't be surprised at anything.
I wouldn't be surprised at anything.
One quick call before we go off. Your question, please, line one.
Yes, I'd like to know why, as a resident of Aylesburg, we should continue to pay taxes when we don't receive the most elementary services from the city, which can include paving of streets. We have potholes big enough to lose cars in.
All right, ma'am, I'm going to have to cut you off and get a response.
Well, if you got a pothole that's big enough to lose a car in, then you give me that address and I'll fill it myself.
And I imagine she's complaining about other services. Are they neglected in that area at all? Or is that just a common complaint?
That's a common complaint all over the city of Newark. We have a refuse collection operation, which I think operates in Aylesburg. We have fire protection, and we have police protection, as best we can provide with the resources we have available.
Thank you, Mayor Gibson, for appearing on Question this evening. If you have any question, you may direct it to Mayor Gibson at the City Hall in Newark. For Question this evening, I'm Dick Minton. Good evening.